So I'm here to talk to you about The Sun is Also a Star. And why am I holding this? Because I hate thumbnails. So I don't have to make one, hopefully. So what's the story on this one? The story is a couple who's, she's very brainiac, she's very cerebral, very based on science, you know, a logical thought. And he's a poet, and he believes in love, and he believes in fate, and they find each other, and they wonder if fate actually has something to do with it, and if people can fall in love instantly or in a short period of time. You know, it's a romantic movie. It's based on the novel of Nicola Yoon, a bestseller apparently, and it also has this current issue about immigration and deportations in the United States. So the director is Russo-Young. She's not that experienced, but it's a strong presence, and it honestly is one of the best things about the movie, is the direction and the cinematography, hands down. She mixes this intimate story, you know, these two characters in these close-ups with the characters in the very intimate way of telling a story, with wide shots of New York and poetic shots of the city, and the city becomes a character, because the girl, she loves Natasha, she loves the city, and New York suddenly becomes this character in this movie, in a beautiful character, in really well shot, in poetically shot, and I think that the direction and the cinematography did the movie way better than it could have been. The cinematographer is Autumn Durald, and well, recently he did Teen Spirit, and I think it's beautiful. And The Sun also has also, I'm going to put this down, I think the thumbnail is done, maybe I'll use it again, I don't know. He uses the light in a beautiful way. The sun also has a presence here, obviously, and he uses it. It's dreamlike. It's beautiful. It's poetic. It's so gorgeous. I loved it. So this is it. This is, let's talk about the writing. So it's a Nicola Yoon novel. I didn't read it. I didn't read anything about this from this author. Apparently, and from what I've been reading, the movie has the spirit of the novel. So the spirit of the novel is being romance, is being two kids falling in love. And the writing, and the writer is, the screenwriter is Tracy Oliver, also not that experienced, well, she's experienced, but not something that I can mention, TV and some movies. She, obviously, this is about choices, and she have she had Nicola Yoon to answer to, and she picks up this thing that is already written, and she has to turn it into a movie. And the choices, well, she has great characters to work with. They're really good characters. They're round, they're deep, they're well constructed, even the secondary characters. But she does this love story, you know. And quite frankly, and it could have been a love story and keep the spirit of the novel, but the immigration stories are so interesting, and they kind of get lost in this teenagers falling in love thing, which is kind of a shame, because the immigration stories were really strong. But I get it, you had to keep the focus on these two characters, but you use some flashbacks, and you use, for instance, I don't want to spoil it for you, but there is this sequence about the explanation of why that store exists, a store, the store of the parents of the male character Daniel, why does it exist, and they do this flashback with graphics and all, and they give the importance to this detail, but they don't give importance to other details, like why is she in this situation. It's just there's a sentence that explains that her father had an encounter with ice. In both characters in both families have a rich story, and it's almost absent here. I mean, we know more about the Daniel that's not the main character. Well, they both are main characters, but the story is about her who's leaving tomorrow, you know. But we know more about Daniel than about Natasha, and I don't know. I think it was a missed opportunity, but again, it's choices, and I think the movie would have been richer if they used these stories a little better. But there is one thing I have to say that I think it was a brilliant detail. In the beginning of the movie, it's still not even plot point one. We're still getting to know the characters. You know, it's the presentation of the characters. We didn't even reach the beginning of the story, and there is this detail. I mean, a subway stops and somebody tells a story, and quite frankly, that little detail just set the mood to the whole movie, and that was brilliant. I mean, the fact that you hear that story, I mean, it just sets the mood and you understand what it's going to be about, and you never forget it. And that's brilliant. That is a brilliant detail in writing that needs to, you know, be brought to light. So what else do I have to say? The actors, they're not that experienced. She's Yara Shahidi and he's Charles Melton. They're supposed to be high school seniors. I'm not sure I believe that. They seem very grown up. I'm not sure I buy that they are high school seniors, but they are gorgeous. They are good actors. They're not bad actors. They are good, believable. They're gorgeous. That's the main thing. I mean, they are gorgeous. Let me tell you this. And I don't say this much. I'm not one that, you know, gets hung up on looks, but I could pay tickets just to look at them. They're gorgeous. Seriously, that so works. It does. And a trivia story that I found out in, and I'm selling it as I read it. I found out in IMDb that apparently the writer, the novel writer, Nicola Yoon, posted a picture of Yara Shahidi in her Instagram and said that they were looking for a male protagonist for this movie. And she asked who would be the perfect protagonist for this movie. And apparently Charles Melton just killed it. People just mentioned him and he won it. So that's why he was hired. Another mention I have to make, it's about John Leguizamo. You know him, maybe not by name, but you know him. He did The Honeymooners, The Happening, he did TV, he did John Wick, two movies of John Wick, The Crash, even Moulin Rouge. You know him. He's probably, and from my research, the most experienced actor here, and he is not used very extensively. Even his story is interesting, and we only hear about it at the end. And even his story is interesting. Why is he doing that interview? Why? We don't know. There are some details that maybe the movie would have been richer if you would have used the details of these rich characters. They are so rich. And you just do this superficial, well, not, you know, moment, because it's a day. And I get it. You have to focus on that day. And I get it. The subway story, I get it. But you could have enriched it, I think, with a little, maybe more experience. I don't know. Another thing I have to say is the soundtrack. It's the responsibility of a guy or girl, I have no idea. I can't pronounce this name. It's Herdis Stefánsdóttir. I can't pronounce it. I'm sorry. Anyway, kudos to you because you picked... it's so present and so it works so well. I mean, I wouldn't buy it normally. It's not my style of music if I'm going to buy it by myself, you know, but it really works. It stuck on my mind because it each song that appeared, oh man, perfect. So good. I had to say this. Kudos to you, Herdis. Okay, so negatives. The love story is not as interesting as the characters' stories. is the immigration stories, and they were not used in they could have been better used. I think this is a negative because the rest is good. I mean, the direction is good, the cinematography is good, the music is good, the actors, well, they're gorgeous to look at. Not sure if I buy it. They're seniors in high school, and yeah, they look at each other perfectly. They talk to each other perfectly. The chemistry completely works until they kiss. The kisses didn't quite... Anyway, but that's a detail. Who is this for? Well, this is for, people say, hopeless romantics. And I say, for people who are waking up. You know, if you are waking up, if you know the term, you know what I mean. You know, it discusses coincidences and the way the universe talks to you. If you are starting to get into this pile of people, you know what I mean. Maybe you get something out of it. You know, for people waking up, let me leave you with this little hint. If you're ready to be in the universe as it is and take advantage of it and finally be happy, you are waking up if you believe in coincidences and you don't think it's random and you start understanding what it means. The male character, it's his fight, and maybe you take something out of it. I had fun, so go to the movies. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and comment, and even if you disagree with me, talk to me about the music, about the characters, about the actors, because without comments and likes and subscriptions, there's no point in doing this, so please give me a hand, okay? Go to the movies. Thank you for watching.